This time on Engine Masters, presented by AMSOIL, we're going to find out what happens when we try and cram 620 horsepower through a 2.5-inch muffler or a 3-inch muffler. And you're going to find out a really easy combo for 600-plus horsepower from a simple 454 Chevy. But first, you know I have to do this, right? Ready? Okay, scientific analysis, 3-inch muffler says... Okay, not much difference. Let's get into the real science. Here is the poor, innocent, big block Chevy that we are gonna attempt to strangle with mufflers. When this thing's running with open headers, it makes 620 horsepower and 580 plus pound-feet of torque with a curve that looks like Scott Weiland's cardiograph. Let me tell you how we're doing it. It has pretty much a bone stock forged 454 bottom end. It does have Wiseco pistons in it for 10.25-to-1 compression. The cylinder heads are an Edelbrock XT. What does that mean? Maybe extra? They're an oval port that's been CNC ported. They're actually pretty good. Up top, we've got a matching oval port Edelbrock Performer RPM air gap intake, a Holley 950 CFM Ultra XP carburetor, and we're going to be shoving the exhaust gases through a set of 2-inch Hooker under chassis headers today. Then there's a camshaft. We have a solid roller in this thing. It's a Comp Cams XR284R. It's got 248 degrees of duration at 50 on the intake lobe. The exhaust is 254. The lift is 654 and 661, and it's on 110 degree lobe separation angle. And now we're gonna roll it into the dyno and find out what happens when you try and shove all of that power through a complete 2.5-inch exhaust system. This looks ridiculous, but it's actually really good because we're gonna mimic an exhaust system just like it might be in your car or crew cab dually as it may be, because this is really long. But the difference between the 2.5- and 3-inch muffler isn't just gonna be the muffler itself, it's gonna be the area of the exhaust tubing in the whole system. And that's why we've set it up this way and why we've included bends like the over the axle and like a tailpipe turnout. So this is gonna give us a real world example of the difference between that 2.5-inch Magnaflow and later on a 3-inch. This time we have oil options. There's the AMSOIL Z-Rod 1030 or the Premium Protection 1040. The Z-Rod is more formulated for a performance kind of guy. They say it's kind of a nicer option for someone who's gonna let an engine sit for a long time, sort of in a typical hot rod that might have 600 horsepower like this. But we've been running the Premium Protection 1040 in this big block, and so that's what we're gonna go with this time. Bam! Ah, spilled everywhere.
Yeah.
Sounds of silence.
Wow.
Would you rev up the water pump?
That's
or what?
Weird.
That's a 600 horsepower solid roller motor you're listening
I know.
To.
Well, it was.
Yeah.
We'll
that's a good
now.
Point.
We know this thing made nearly 620 horsepower the last time we ran it. Now we've got the 2.5-inch exhaust on here. Let's see how much power it kills.
It is so quiet.
Wow. I know, you so like that
quiet.
Part
how much
of it.
Horsepower would you give up for that kind of quietness, though?
We're about to find out exactly how much. The thing I'm interested in, actually, is how it's going to change the tune-up. Is it going to run richer because it can't get air out of the motor?
Well, we've got an O2 meter in it, so we'll find out.
You know why you really want that 2.5-inch exhaust? Is because an engine really likes back pressure, and
really?
you lose torque if the exhaust is too big.
Oh yeah, that's,
yeah. Watch.
That's already proven an established fact, right?
It's an established. Yeah. I read it on the internet.
And you've become an internet expert, I've heard.
All Okay, we just took our engine that made 620 horsepower and turned it into a 600 horsepower engine. And we used to make, what was it, 580
584 pound-feet?
And we turned that into 556. Right now, we're gonna pull up the test with it on open headers with an 18-inch collector extension and no muffler whatsoever. Wow.
Wow.
So here's the curve looking at the black line with 2.5-inch mufflers and full exhaust. The red line is open exhaust with an 18-inch collector extension. You can see you're losing power everywhere, except for, strangely enough, down here, 3,200 and below. But I'll remind you, a lot of people are like, well, that's why I drive my car anyway. This is all at wide open throttle, not necessarily indicative of what you're doing on the street at part throttle, because if you're on it, you're going through 3,500 RPM really quickly, especially if you have any kind of like decent torque converter.
The other thing that it's all of?
What?
Is the exhaust system. That's the longest exhaust system
yeah.
I've ever seen. That's
huge.
That's over the axles and turnouts and...
Now look, it used the same fuel making less power, so is it richer?
It's a little richer.
This comparison is looking at the air-fuel mixture here with no mufflers and here is with mufflers. So higher on the chart is leaner, meaning less fuel, and lower is richer, meaning more fuel. It did get richer with the mufflers because it's not moving as much air through the engine.
I think it probably has to do with the length of the muffler and the way it signals the carburetor. I mean, that whole air track doesn't start or end at the intake manifold. It starts at the carburetor and ends at the tip of the muffler.
Yep.
And all of that's changing the resonance wave or the reflective wave throughout the whole air system. And so it probably is just a different signal to the carburetor.
So what we're looking at here with the 2.5-inch exhaust system is 556 pound-feet of torque, 600 horsepower. So now we're gonna go put on the 3-inch and hopefully it improves that a little bit.
It's got to.
It has to.
I bet it makes it louder, right?
Think so?
Oh, then yeah. We can hear it run.
Yeah, because it is depressing. We threw away 20 horsepower and how many pound-feet? 30?
Like 30,
yeah.
You know, though, in all fairness, when you're driving a street car, those really, really short exhaust systems that are way too loud, that just your head's
super
doing
annoying.
Noise after 30 miles, you have to get out and beg for someone else to drive your car.
Let me check your pulse, hold on. No, I'm afraid it's time to go. What we just learned is that if you really hate horsepower and want to kill torque, the 2.5-inch exhaust system is the perfect product for that. So now we're gonna step up to the 3-incher and find out what happens, but I wanna make a couple points. First, we're using the exact same model of Magnaflow muffler for both of these tests, and importantly, they are the same length and width in both cases because that really makes a difference. Now have a look at that shot of a 2.5-inch system versus a 3-inch system. Kinda obvious what's gonna happen here, isn't it?
When I was working on the oil rigs, my crew boss would have probably fired me for the double wrenching like this.
This has to make it better, right?
Yes.
What if it doesn't?
It's gonna help a lot.
Okay, we took off the 2.5-inch exhaust and we're throwing the 3 on right now and we're looking to find our 620 horsepower again.
Think we'll get there?
No.
How about pretty close?
We wanted to put an O2 sensor in the exhaust so we could see if the air-fuel ratio changes with the different exhaust sizes, but I didn't feel like welding anything. So this is a clamp-on oxygen sensor band with a little gasket. So you can install an oxygen sensor without having to weld. We're using these Magnaflow stainless steel mufflers, and these are good because check it out. They are straight all the way through. No obstructions, no chambers, no baffles, just a perforated core and some packing in there. In fact, I think one of the things is this test would be more dramatic if we used a bad muffler. These are pretty good. Okay, Dulcich, what I'm gonna need you to do is run out there and I need you to calculate the total volumetric difference in pipe size for the full length of 2.5 versus 3.
Oh, wow, the cubic capacity?
Right, can
you do that? You want it in cubic inches or cc's? What's 25 feet times 3 inches
exactly.
times pi r squared?
Yeah, that's it. I think it sounds a little bit more grown up, you know?
You hear a little more growl than the 2.5.
A little more, Here we go. Essentially as good as open exhaust.
Very impressive.
Very close.
Really? Yeah.
It's way louder. 570 pound-feet of torque, 614 horsepower, and look how flat that crazy torque curve is. Boom.
Wow.
The 3-inch is better everywhere except for down here below 3,500, where the, I'm guessing the engine's just not moving enough air for
it
to really care. But up here, it's freight training, so call up open headers with an 18-inch extension on it. So now we're looking at a blue line that indicates an open header with an 18-inch extension. Black line, 3-inch exhaust. Red line, 2.5-inch exhaust. It's interesting that way down here, 3,200 and below, it's actually making more torque with the exhaust system on it. We're thinking a function of basically the collector length. Extension length before airflow actually starts to take over. And then as soon as there's some demand for airflow, open header's the way to go. But look how close the 3-incher is matching it up here.
Yeah, they're really close.
Yeah.
The 3-inch is definitely the way to go.
Once again, I think we proved the obvious on Engine Masters.
We do it so well.
I know, it's true. 3-inch exhaust, sure enough, makes more power than 2.5-inch exhaust. The thing that surprised me the most is that those Magnaflow 3-inchers almost didn't kill power at all. I mean, I don't think enough that would be noticeable by the seat of your pants.
It may be obvious, but that might be the ammo you need to take to your muffler guy when you say, I want a 3-inch exhaust system, and he says, you're crazy! That's
because
way too big, and you need the back pressure.
I know.
Yeah.
That's happened to me so many times. You go to a muffler shop, oh yeah, you know, your engine needs a little bit of back pressure. I think we disproved that right now with that 2.5-inch system killing a bunch of power compared to the 3.
And even the open headers for that matter.
That's true.
Zero back pressure.
Zero back pressure. The other thing that we did off camera is that we weighed both the exhaust systems, and that was a surprise to me.
And me too.
The 3-inch exhaust only weighed 10 pounds more than the 2.5-inch exhaust, and we had a big hanking long exhaust system on this thing.
I was expecting a whole bunch more, like, you know, 20, 25 pounds, so.
But this part might surprise the audience. You know how much that complete 3-inch exhaust system weighed? 82 pounds. That's a lot to be lugging around. That might be a new argument for turndowns.
I was surprised that the 2.5 was at 72 pounds. I was expecting, you know, 40 or 50 pounds.
Yeah, I know.
You don't know the true facts until you do the measurement and you weigh it, you check it, you dyno test it, and you find out.
And that's exactly what we do here on Engine Masters, presented by AMSOIL. Come back to us next time, but meanwhile, check out motortrendondemand.com for gearhead video 24 hours a day. And make sure to check us out on social media. On Instagram, it's Engine Masters. On Facebook, it's Hot Rod Engine Masters. And come back for more dyno violence on Engine Masters, presented by AMSOIL. Hey, guess what? If you're on MotorTrendOnDemand.com, you get access to Engine Masters 30 days before anybody else. And there's an exclusive show on there with Dulcich and myself that's called Roadkill Garage. Now, here's a sneak peek at the next episode of Engine Masters that's live right now on MotorTrend On Demand. This is your camshaft for a girly hydraulic roller lifter. This is your camshaft for a manly and violent solid roller lifter. And this time on Engine Masters presented by AMSOIL, we're gonna help you decide which one is right for you. Go check out this episode of Engine Masters now at Motor Trend On Demand. Okay, scientific analysis, 3-inch muffler says. Okay, not much difference. Okay, that was 2.5, let's go with the 3. Ready? Okay, no real difference.